Hi, and welcome to our listening simulation. This is a classroom demonstration to show how students with hearing loss hear in the classroom despite noise and with the added benefit of Roger. You're currently listening to me through a pair of Sky M70 level hearing aids. They are programmed to a 30 dB flat loss, and they're being routed through the plant finder directly into the camera. Right now, my voice is only being heard through the hearing aids. While I am wearing a Roger touchscreen mic, you can tell that it's muted because of the flashing red light. We know for students with hearing loss wearing their hearing technology, be it hearing aids, CIs, Bahas, for their full wakeful day is critical, but unfortunately those devices aren't enough in the modern classroom because there we have teachers who are moving around the classroom throughout the day and teaching as they go. We have peers discussing and learning from each other, and we have multimedia that augments the lessons. And studies have shown that classrooms can be as loud as 65 to 75 dB. That's as loud as a running vacuum cleaner. Not even trying to learn in that. So for our first simulation, we're actually going to turn on some classroom noise at 70 dB, and it'll be playing through a Bluetooth speaker.
And the level of effort that you have to put in to hear it. Today, children, we're going to learn about space exploration. With the Artemis Project, NASA will land the first woman and the next man on the moon by 2024, using innovative technologies to explore more of the lunar surface than ever before. In the second part of the simulation, we're going to consider what happens in an interactive classroom when students have questions, but only the teacher has a microphone. Okay, class, we are going to conclude our unit on space this Friday with an exam, so this is your time to ask me any questions that you might have. Yes, Steve.
Is the test going to be open?
It will not be. So we're going to do that again now, and the next time, Steve is going to use the pass-around mic. Okay, class, we are going to conclude our unit on space this Friday. Does anyone have any questions?
Is the test going to be open? Note.
No, it won't be, Steve. Now, for our student with hearing loss, they may not have heard Steve's question the first time around, or they may have misunderstood my answer. So that's where the pass-around mic becomes very helpful. This last part of the simulation, we're going to consider how multimedia interacts with the modern classroom. Our multimedia hub can be plugged into any instructional media source. And you know what, so can our touchscreen mic. So you might be wondering, why do I need a multimedia hub if I already have a touchscreen mic? Where this device becomes helpful is if the class is going to be watching a video and the teacher is going to be talking during the video. So let's take a listen to how this works if only the touchscreen mic is plugged into the computer. Class, in our exam on Friday, this video is going to be 10% of your score, so I want you to pay close attention to it. It's a speech by President Kennedy.
And there's some facts and figures in here.
And it is one of the great adventures of all time. Its conquest deserves the best of all mankind. For we meet in an hour of change, in a decade of hope, in an age of knowledge. Even though I realize that this is, in some measure, an act of faith and vision, for we do not now know what benefits await us. But if I were to say, my fellow citizens, that we shall send to the moon, 240,000 miles away, a giant rocket carrying all the equipment needed for survival on an untried mission to an unknown celestial body, and then return it safely to Earth, re-entering the atmosphere at speeds of over 25,000 miles per hour, and do all this and do it right. Out, then we must be bold.
Let's try that listening simulation one more time with the multimedia plug, the multimedia hub plugged in, and me wearing the teacher mic again.
Exploration of space will go ahead, and it is one of the great adventures of all time. Its conquest deserves the best of all mankind.
That's President Kennedy's voice.
When we meet in an hour of change, in a decade of hope, in an age of knowledge, even though I realize that this is, in some measure, an act of faith and vision, for we do not now know what benefits await us.
Who is this guy? He's important for the test.
That we shall send to the moon 240,000 miles away,
240,000 miles away,
carrying all the equipment needed for survival on an untried mission to an unknown celestial body, and then return it safely to Earth, re-entering the atmosphere at speeds of over 25,000 miles per hour.
25,000 miles per hour.
And do all this and do it right before this decade is out, and then we must be bold.
So there's a special feature in Roger technology that mixes these signals together. So that way students, all the students, can have access to both the teaching input of the instructional media and of the teacher's voice. Classrooms today are busy, and they are complex listening environments. These Roger transmitters that we've listened to today, they're not luxury items for students with hearing loss. They're in fact critical to be sure that they have the same access to all the learning the classroom has to provide that their normal hearing peers hear as well. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please let us know if you have any questions.